Alex, we're seeing more large silos on farm now and the need for recirculation systems to help our fumigation with phosphine.
Well, recirculation systems are actually really good at giving us the ability to distribute gas evenly in our gas tight sealable storages.
So passive recirculation or a ground level application is not powered. It enables us to put the phosphine in at the ground level and it's connected to the headspace of the silo and to the bottom, allowing that gas to distribute throughout the silo versus a powered one like we've got here.
Yeah, it's like this one. We've got a small fan in play, which is then drawing air from inside the silo, recirculating. We've obviously got application space here inside the chamber to, again, try and achieve that powered recirculation, so distribute the gas as quickly as we can from top to bottom and achieve a lethal concentration in a shorter time frame.
So without this recirculation, we're looking at phosphine moving at 6 metres per day through the grain roughly, but this will speed that process up.
Yep, absolutely. So we know in our larger storages, 300 tonne and above, with a powered recirculation system, we can actually do our fumigation in 10 days. But if we're just doing a surface level application, we know that does blow out to 20 days as per the label. So they really are quite an effective tool at being able to improve the speed of our fumigations.
Yeah, sure. And in terms of components?
The first one in our powered recirculation system is having a fan of sufficient size. The other is having a vessel that's going to be big enough to store the amount of phosphine tablets or blankets that we need. And the third one is really having an explosion-proof panel. So in the event that our fan did stop, we need to ensure that there's a panel fitted that does give us the ability to release the pressure inside that vessel.
Yeah, sure. So an alternative to having a separate fumigation box would actually be to still plumb a fan into the headspace and the ground level of the silo, but put the phosphine in the headspace like we traditionally would, rather than into the box here.
Exactly, but we know that these systems, a very similar format to this, can actually be applied to cone bottom silos as well. Typically using one of the aeration fans on a cone bottom silo, a box similar to this is usually fitted under the silo itself. And again, it's just a powered recirculation system to try and speed up the distribution of our gas.
Most importantly, I guess we should note that any fumigation chamber needs to be gas tight sealable to the Australian standard 2628, and always follow the label directions when people are doing fumigation. But if people have questions or want more information?
For more information, the best place to go to is 1800 Weevil is a hotline to get in contact with one of the grain storage team, or going to the website at storegrain.com.au.